Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, I'll be showing you how to set up RetroPie on your Raspberry Pi. RetroPie is one of the best solutions for turning your Raspberry Pi into a retro gaming machine. It has support for over 50 different systems, including the popular ones such as the SNES and the PlayStation 1. With the newer versions of the Raspberry Pi such as the Pi 5, you are even able to emulate Nintendo 64 games using the included emulator cores with RetroPie. The newer Raspberry Pis will always get you the best retro gaming experience thanks to their increased performance. However, it is still possible to use older versions such as the Raspberry Pi 3, just you will need to stick with the older game controllers such as the SNES. For this guide, we will personally be using the Raspberry Pi 5. Additionally, while you can use a keyboard to use RetroPie, we highly recommend using a controller. It makes playing most console games significantly simpler, and mapping controls is just a little bit easier as you have less buttons to worry about. When it comes to operating systems, we highly recommend that you start with Raspberry Pi OS Lite. In particular, if you are running a Raspberry Pi 4 or newer, we highly recommend you go with the 64-bit release. Some of the included emulators will just work better with this and be able to better utilize your Raspberry Pi's RAM. Additionally, we are recommending the Lite variant of Raspberry Pi OS as it comes with significantly less packages pre-installed, meaning more performance can be dedicated to your retro gaming. For recording purposes, we will be using Raspberry Pi OS Bookworm Desktop Edition. Once you are ready to turn your Raspberry Pi into a retro gaming machine using RetroPie, open up the terminal or connect to your Raspberry Pi using SSH. Before we begin setting up RetroPie, we should first ensure our operating system is up to date. The first part of this process is to update the package list by typing in sudo apt update and pressing enter. Once that completes, upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade -y and pressing enter. We now need to install all the packages we require to run the RetroPie setup script. Installing these packages is as easy as typing in sudo apt install git dialog and then -y and pressing enter. Finally, we can now use the git package that we just installed to grab the latest version of the RetroPie setup script. All we need to do for this is to type in git space clone space hyphen hyphen dep equals 1 space https colon symbol forward slash github.com/retropie/retropie-setup.git and pressing enter. We now need to change into the directory we just cloned by typing in cd space retropie-setup and pressing enter. With us now in the right directory, let's run the RetroPie setup script by typing in sudo space /retropie_setup.sh and pressing enter. The script will now download any additional packages it requires to operate. This should only take a minute or two. This first message is basically just warning you that you should never have paid for a RetroPie image. Since we haven't, all we need to do is press enter to proceed. Now, if you are running a 64-bit operating system like we are, you will see a quick warning that it is not yet officially supported. Don't worry, as the vast majority of the emulators work better with 64-bit, not worse. Now press enter to continue. While the RetroPie setup script allows you to modify what it installs, the best way to install RetroPie is to just stick with the basic install option. Ensure that basic install is selected and then press the enter key. This next message will tell you that it's about to install the packages from the core and main branches. To proceed with installing RetroPie to your Raspberry Pi, use the arrow keys to select the yes option and then press enter. RetroPie will now take some significant time to compile itself and install. This process took us about 40 minutes with a Raspberry Pi 5, so now is the perfect time to take a break if you need one. If you are wondering why we are using the install script rather than just the image, the reason is the image is rarely updated, has zero support for modern versions of the Raspberry Pi, and is just a bit lacking. The RetroPie setup script, however, is maintained quite often, giving us the latest available versions at all times. When RetroPie is finished installing to your Raspberry Pi, you should be taken back to the RetroPie setup script. We aren't quite done yet, as we will want RetroPie to start when your Raspberry Pi powers on. Having to manually launch RetroPie every time you want to play any of your retro games will be a bit of a painful process, especially with the way RetroPie works. Luckily, this script makes getting RetroPie to start at boot incredibly easy. Now use the arrow keys to select the configuration/tools option and press enter. Now find the option labeled auto start and press enter. Now to get RetroPie to start at boot, just highlight the start emulation station at boot option and press enter. If successful, you will see a message saying emulation station is set to start at boot. Press enter to proceed back to the RetroPie setup tool. Now use the arrow keys again to select the cancel option at the bottom of the screen and then press enter. While we still have the configuration menu open, the next thing we'll want to do is enable the Samba shares. These shares will allow you to very easily copy over any of your ROMs to your RetroPie. This network format is supported by almost every major operating system, from Windows to Linux to macOS. Now use your arrow keys to navigate down till you see the option labeled Samba and select it. Within this menu, select the Install RetroPie Samba Shares option and press Enter. RetroPie will automatically install and set up these shares, so you don't have to do anything else to get them working on your Raspberry Pi. If it was successful, you should see the message Installed and Enabled Shares. Simply press Enter to return back to the RetroPie setup script. We will now want to return to the configuration screen by selecting the cancel option at the bottom of the page. There are numerous other options on this screen, such as the ability to control Bluetooth and more. You can now take some time to explore these, or you can now reboot your Raspberry Pi into its retro gaming machine mode. To reboot your Pi into the RetroPie interface, select the back option and then select Perform Reboot. You can ignore this next warning screen, as we don't actually have emulation station running yet. So use your arrow keys to select the Yes option and then press Enter to restart your Raspberry Pi. It should only take a few seconds for your Raspberry Pi to boot into RetroPie. Once done, you'll be taken to the welcome screen. At this point, you'll want to plug in any game controller that you might intend on using. For our example, we'll be using a tried and tested Xbox controller. Whatever input method you've chosen, hold down a button on it to begin configuring it. Now map your game controller to the controls shown on the screen. If you want to skip any of these, just hold down an already selected button. If you make any mistakes, you can fix this up later on. Once you're happy with your configuration, select the OK button to proceed to the RetroPie menus. At the moment, we only have the RetroPie configuration screen listed here. If we open it up, we can see the variety of options that we can use to modify how RetroPie runs on our Raspberry Pi. This is useful to find if you ever need to make any changes to your retro gaming machine. This is also the same screen you'll use if you ever want to pair a Bluetooth controller to your Raspberry Pi. It also allows you to set up some additional functionality, such as RetroArch's NetPlay. Now, there's no point in converting your Raspberry Pi into a retro gaming machine if you don't have any games on it. This is where those Samba shares we enabled earlier come in hand. These next few steps will show you a simple way that you can access these shares from a Windows PC. These steps aren't too different to other desktop operating systems like Ubuntu or macOS. Now, on your Windows PC, open File Explorer and then select the Network tab in the sidebar. If everything has worked nicely, you should actually already see your Raspberry Pi listed here. The name might differ if you have given a different host name to your Raspberry Pi. However, if you don't see your Raspberry Pi, don't stress out yet. If you know the IP address of your Raspberry Pi, you can still easily connect to the Samba shares. Now, using the address bar at the top, type in /// followed by the IP address of your Raspberry Pi followed by the /. You may now be prompted to enter network credentials to access this share. You should be able to just use your username and password for your Raspberry Pi to connect. You'll now see a few different shares that RetroPie set up on your Raspberry Pi. The two most important ones here are the ROMs and BIOS folders. Some emulators require a separate BIOS file to operate. However, for this guide, we'll just be focusing on the ROMs folder. Opening up the ROMs share, you should see a folder for every individual system that RetroPie supports. You'll want to copy your games into the relevant folder. For example, PlayStation games would go in the PSX folder. Please note, if your ROM is still within a .zip file or any other archive format, you'll want to extract it before copying it over. Once you've copied your games over, you'll need to restart RetroPie for it to actually be aware of your new ROMs. To restart RetroPie, you'll need to press whichever button you assign to the start button. In the menu that appears, you'll want to select Quit at the bottom. And then you'll want to select the Restart Emulation Station option. When asked if you really want to restart, select Yes. Once your Raspberry Pi finishes rebooting, you should see all of your games now listed here. You can switch between different consoles by pressing left or right on your controller. Now, let us see how our Raspberry Pi Retro gaming machine handles some of these more intense games. As you can see from the next few bits of footage, our Raspberry Pi does an incredibly good job at handling retro games from the PlayStation and Nintendo 64 system. Nintendo 64 is the more impressive of the two, just because the Raspberry Pi used to really struggle with it with the early days of RetroPie. But now, it's almost all completely playable with little to no issues. Hopefully, at this point, you will also manage to get RetroPie up and running on your Raspberry Pi and successfully turned it into a very lightweight and low-powered retro gaming machine. If you wanted to take this even further, you could easily turn this into a pretty nifty arcade machine. If you have found this video to be helpful, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.